Good evening. Today, 9th of February, we are making a just overview class of Python. Some of you have already done it, some of you have not yet started it. But first thing, we have to be motivated that why we have to learn Python. Because Python is a, and there's some confusion whether we have to learn C and Python together. Some student might ask whether C, Java, Python. It's my personal opinion, I must say, that whenever you come to the computer science career, C is your, it should be your mother tongue. So there is no alternative to C. Python cannot replace your knowledge of C because C is almost like machine language. It can talk with anything. But then why Python? Because of Python, but C is good, but C is a kind of language which has to be run on an embedded system, or program components do not distribute to this machine or that machine at one runtime. Because right now, when are you opening a Gmail through your IBM PC, laptop PC, or Mac, or Android phone, or iPhone, the Gmail has to be operated in all the platforms. So nowadays, programs, say any Android app or any iOS app, it doesn't know where you have to work on, whether it's a Intel based your laptop, whether it's ARM based. So the program has to be well aware of the context, and it doesn't know which where to learn. So that kind of programming C is very not suited for. So there is a language comes the Java, Python. Then somebody may ask, why not Java? There is Java, whenever it started in 1996 onwards by the that time the Sun Solaris company, they have made it has to be open, but later on due to some business scenarios, Oracle has to procure Java, their Sun microsystem. So Java is that way not open. Even Google has also forsaken the path of Java. So but whenever this Python was developed in 1990 onwards, in fact Python is an older language than Java. It's meant to be designed by this particular gentleman, that's so Guido van Rossum. He make it open, that it should be always open. So C is open language, so C has to be run on any platform, that is great. But Java cannot be said like that. Java is not that way open. Open means a lot of restrictions, issues by the Oracle. Then the C hash is also very powerful language. More powerful sometimes C++ and even Java, but C hash is again the proprietary language of Microsoft. You know, the Microsoft dominance in the software market is not that great right now. So that is the reason you have to learn multiple languages. Only one language you don't have to learn. You have to learn multiple languages. Every language has some its own features. So whenever you have to run an embedded function then C is great. And whenever you want an Android app, then maybe C is not that great. Even the Python is not great. Maybe Java is there, and nowadays Kotlin is there. This language is coming. So you have to learn all these languages. But most basic thing is C you have to learn. Then if you can learn C++, great. C++ also pretty strong language, and still it has a lot of demand. And then my suggestion is Python ahead of Java. That's it. Python, what is the advantage of it? The Python is it can be run any place, anywhere. So that Python runs on a virtual machine. What is basically a virtual machine? The concept is same from Java. On the virtual machine, that it builds up a machine, a remote machine, and runs on it there. That is the reason code is portable. Even the class file that is portable, it runs on Python virtual machine. Concept is Java virtual machines and Python virtual machine, or these all virtual machines are same. Remember, Python came earlier, but Python is, why is Python becoming popular? Because the two things. One is Java is taken by the Oracle. That is one reason the Python is more prominent. Even Google support Python. YouTube is written in Python. A lot of applications, whatever you were seeing in Python, a lot of apps, the back end, most of the cases is in Python, modern days. And another is the language. Another thing is Python is, that is a technical thing. Python, your variable declaration is checked at the runtime. Like C, it is at the compile time, whenever you have to declare a variable, you have to declare that it is an integer, it is a character, it is a floating point, you have to declare it right now. That is called strongly typed language. It is same for it, and statically typed, that you have to statically, means you have to declare it earlier. Even Java is also there, you have to statically type before using it, you have to declare it. There's some good points and bad points on it. Bad point is that the runtime it cannot change. That is the reason Python is that way. It is very good glue language. Glue language means it can contact with any other APIs, application programming interface. It's a kind of a glue. So that is that it is not statically typed. So it has to be dynamically typed. Okay, so that it is run slower. So C++ run pretty fast, maybe 10 times faster than Python. But why we are going for all Python? Because nowadays computer CPU is much cheaper. You have a 8-core CPU that fit pretty fast. So there speed is not important. It is important is the development cost, personnel who has good knowledge in C and all these things. C programs are huge, difficult to maintain. Python is development type is quick. Say if it is a C, it is a 1 week job, it can be done. Maybe 1 week job, it's maybe 1,000 lines in Python, it can be done. Maybe 50 lines programs in maybe half a day. So these are the kinds of advantages that Python does have, and that's the reason is Python popular. And another great reason is, like C, Python is open, that is one, but Python, a lot of libraries are already there. So if you quickly develop any application, all libraries are built in. Like one kind of library is called NumPy. I think those who knows, some of you are already aware of Python. So NumPy is totally developed by C++. So whenever you declare NumPy, then it will be as good as almost C. So that's it. So why you are learning Python? In a short, that whenever you want to write a program which is web ready and which is has to be your application should be run your desktop, mobile, background, the Python is a language. So that is a de facto language. It is free. The main competition comes from it is R and Java. R is also open source language, but R is mainly popular in USA and all this, but right now Python is a great ahead. C and Python you have to learn together side by side. My suggestion is C, definitely you must focus, and then Python you can learn is from other end. So one spectrum is C, that is a assembly language, another spectrum is Python. And if somebody may ask me which are any other language, I think C and then C++. Then if you have time, then one Android application development, that is Kotlin is there and Flutter is there, both are good. This Kotlin, Flutter, Java, they are coming in the same group. They will help you to Android app development. With Python also, you can make an Android app in desktop app. Everything can be done in Python, which is slower. So Python is there where you can have a lot of numerical, video, artificial intelligence, machine learning. There is machine learning one area I'll talk to it, that in your programming classes right now in Python on your data structure classes will tell you this is the algorithm, this is the data, and you give the output. But right now in the modern day, we have a lot of labeled data is available. Say we have lot of doctors are giving them maybe brain tumor scans. My favorite, one of my topic is brain tumor scan. There are maybe 9 type of classification of brain tumor from say 1 to 9, and various categories of brain tumor. And there's lots of images which are already detected, and that is called already typed data is available. So we can develop a program where you already we typed this is the scan image, this is the type 1 classification, type 2 classification of this brain tumor. Then you can give an unknown image, it can be detected. So what is want to say that is right now all the datas are there, and you put the data into a intelligent program, the program can find it out. The program can write program. That is called machine learning. The machine learning is a kind of advanced thing, that whenever you have a lot of known things are there, you give the pump data to a program, and the program will write a program how to detect, because you have only leveled answers is there. You have you know which is what, and all these answers are there. Right now, in internet age, a lot of likes you are giving in your Facebook or Instagram, so you can have customer feedback or your mood, how the user is interacting, everything can be labeled. So that's great. We'll come to that machine learning. So Python is de facto language of machine learning. So whenever a lot of data is being generated at various places, at different kinds of data, huge amount of data, there the C cannot handle because it has to be multiple process and all these things. So that is the thing. And he's a great man. He solely developed the Python language in the 1990s, and he's a BTech guy. Then his professors get him out of the programming and let him do the complete his BTech degree, and maybe after 3 years. But he's so dedicated. Right? He was in Google. Right now he was in Dropbox. I think now he has left Google and joined as another company. He is a great man. So okay. So let's go to the next slide. So Python is that I am discussing. It's a Python is a it comes from say it's another program pkinter, probably learn in the GUI graphics user interface. This is Django. Some of you have mentioned that is a Wave framework. It is a great framework. Another is a Flask is there. Flask is that complicated. So if you quickly learn this, we'll try to cover the Flask and Django framework. So basic Python you have to cover it. And this Plotlib, Matplotlib, another doctor, medicine doctor has developed the Matplotlib, natural language processing. There are lots of other extension. NumPy is very essential to Python. It is a what is basically NumPy is that you can have a contiguous memory location like C array, like C array, but array is not in built-in in Python. Python is a built-in is list. List is more powerful, but list has some limitation of list. List has not fast, and NumPy that deficiency taken care of. NumPy you have to import it. Import NumPy as np. There's a standard command, and NumPy you can have a contiguous memory location, huge amount of memory location, one dimensional, two dimensional of the same type of memory, maybe integer 8 bit, integer 16 bit, integer 32 bit, integer 64 bit, float, date. Float character, sorry, all this same type of thing, contiguous in memory, you can process it. Not only you can process it, you can get the max or you can get mean a little bit, but after NumPy, you have a SciPy, then all the linear algebra calculation, all of your eigenvectors and all these things which are essential for linear algebra, for machine learning, it can be done by SciPy. Then one Matplotlib, there's visualization. It gives you the plot, graph, and various kinds of plot. You say the plot, it can be visualized on any platform, on laptop, on your mobile phone. This is great. So a lot of things. So these are already built in, and forever is almost free. And you can get, if you want to develop a code, not have to scratch. Everything is there. If you have memory, GitHub, somebody has a GitHub account, so you can have a lot of code, you can just borrow it, you can develop it. That's great of Python. This is the same thing, I think Python, there's some rules of Python. Python, it is always agreed that beautiful is better than, what I see, it is basically saying that Python code, there is no semicolon. So how to understand the it says the syntax, the indentation they have used is like, every Python code is indented, and my suggestion is you should better maintain with 4-letter indentation, or you can do 2-letter, but it should be consistent, so that if you have a defined function, then you have to 4 extra spaces. The next line, indentation is kind of a poetry, like how can I remember poetry or a song of Rabindranath Gitobitan. So there is a indentation, you never see line jumps of it. So whenever you say visual representation of a poetry or any song or any Rabindranath Tagore song, you see the syntax and you see the uneven lines or even characters. Anyway, that automatically human brains are more focused to lines and spaces. If it is free of clutter like semicolon, that we generally never in our prose we hardly use semicolon, either full stop or comma. But Foodstuff of Comma definitely is a limitation. He maintains that it should be clutter-free. So that's great. Another great is that whenever you copy-paste a code, most of the cases in Java and C, you can copy-paste and it would run. When in Python, it would not run. If you copy-paste, then you have to make indentation correct. So then the programmer thinks little bit of his own logic or her own logic into it. So that is the reason. Python is, you can, it is, these are the rules of Python. So Python is meant to say, if sometimes those who are new to Python, those who are already known C, some, most of you know the C, I know, and C++, but whenever I see there's a lot of differentiation out there, you must be see why it is not statically typed. The reason of statically typed is, it has to be dynamic so that at runtime data can come. That's great. But it is strongly typed. But that means runtime change, but runtime you cannot put a floating point, you cannot put a string to a integer. That's great. You have to be casting. So that is there in. These are the design issues. Whenever Python has been designed, they make it so that it has to be run in a platform, on web platform in 1990 onwards and all this. This, that's it. And it has to be simpler. If it's a, in the C++, I've told you, if it's a 100 lines in Python, should be maybe five to six lines. Another thing is that Python give a lot of data structures is there. Like we all know from school level, we learn it from, I think you are all aware of school level, the set, your set, it's like our alphabet set, it's capital A to capital is 26, there is no duplication of A. So this set is in mathematics is very, very important. That what is the concept of set? Say if the alphabet letters, there is no order, then say it can occur any place. So it is just collection of 626 A to Z. So, and there has to be unique, that means no duplication of this. This is, it is all kinds of theoretical computation data, because you can build a set in Python. That is great. Then Python, another great thing is you can have a list. List is kind of an array concept, but list is, every item can be any damn thing. It can be integer, it can be float point. And that is also a problem, because if it's an array, you can quickly find it out by through index. That thing is taken care of by NumPy. And list is that you can have a multiple items, it can be different items. The list is there. That is, the list is very powerful. That is, in C you don't have. Then is another concept called set, I have told you. Then another concept is tuple. What is basically tuple? Tuple, it is a list is third bracket opening and third bracket ending, that is list. And set is second bracket opening and second bracket ending with separated by commas. And tuple is first bracket opening, first bracket end, items separated by comma. Tuple is that it cannot be changed. So it is unmutable. So that is great. Tuple generally consists of maximum 10 elements, but there is no restraint. You can have put 10 to any items, but generally recommended, if it's a 10 item, that is great. Tuple it cannot change. Like our first name, I should put my first name in my tuple, not as a list, because my first name is already decided. It is not changed. My last name, my sex, or my date of birth. So these are the things put in a tuple. That gives a self-extension. Tuple is there. Then another thing is called dictionary. Dictionary is a, I'll come to second bracket opening, second bracket ending, and there is a key and the values, the key value pairs, so that you can, dictionary, it's a lot of programming will be simple, like our open dictionary. Whenever you see English to English dictionary, you see the left hand side, you find it, and the right hand side, the meaning. So dictionary is built in. So for problem solving, whatever the tools is required, it is built in the Python. That's great. That is, it is not there in C. Some of it in Java is there, but not all. Python gives, like I've told, four types, and when to use what, I will discuss it. And some of the sorting, whether you want to sort it, data, different algorithms are built in. You don't have to write program. So max, min are definitely there. Sort is there. So some built-in, all these data structures, routines are already there. So you have to build upon it. Okay. So that's it. So let's go to the next slide. Yes, dynamic languages are more productive. Productive means it's quickly developed and quickly run. Python codes are readable. That is the reason, because it has indentation is there. So by indent, you know which under what. But indentation is also, we recommend in C programming, but if nobody maintains, actually the good programmers, the very good programmers, they do not make a indented code because they want that their code should be a secret. So that is the reason they hardly use command lines, they hardly use indentation. But here in Python, it makes a programmer a must that you must make your indentation. Whether you have made command lines or not, that doesn't matter, but you should maintain which comes under it, which. So is a definition of a class, definition of a function, the body of the function must be indented. Okay, so in C that is not mandatory. If somebody can write a one long sentence, is a function, nobody can understand, but that's the programmer is the expert, is make it a intentional so that nobody can understand. So that is not possible in Python. Python, everything is in, has to be indented, that they force one kind of documentation, whether programmer wants it or not, it will be documented, because programmer is read once and change many times, view many more times. So that is the logic. So, and programmer's time is much more precious than your code, your running time. So CPU and this pretty cheap. So Python programmer costs costly. So that is the thing, code should be shorter. I have told you the very built-in high level data types. The different data types I have mentioned, when to use list, when to use tuple, when to use dictionary, when to use what is frozen set. I'll come on to this. Just to say what is difference between set and frozen set. Set is a unique item, collection of unique items, is a set, and if you, and is a second bracket opening and items and second bracket end. But if you say frozen onto before it, frozen set, then it, that is immutable. So you cannot add any element to it and delete. Then what is the difference between frozen set and tuple? Frozen set, every item should be only one condition of a set, and frozen set means you cannot add anything to it or delete into it. But tuple is same thing, you cannot add anything to it, delete it to it, but tuple items can be duplicated. So that is the difference between frozen set and tuple. This is a very typical popular question whenever you will take in Viva, it will be asked in your Viva. So be prepared to this. Okay, so same thing. This is the Python 2.x. right now you don't have to learn, early it's very popular, so you must know difference. One difference is Python 3 you have to be this pre-interview command, very subtle differences. So this is, I've already told, this Python code source code must be .py, and bytecode like C, it will be like C, you know, the bytecode is obj files, or here bytecode is like Java, it is a dot class. It's a dot Java here from Java, and here is a dot class, and here it is a PYC, that is Python class probably the name, and it runs on PVM. PVM is definitely written in C, C++. So C, C++ you cannot avoid. So all because PVM, and these are the very expert programmer written in, and this PVM should be on machine, on any, it's actually, it runs on a CPU, it runs on a maybe ARM based machine on your mobile, or Intel based machine on your laptop or desktop. So that's it. So this is it. Virtual machine, it runs slower, but it's a more manageable. It any machine, the hardware machine busy, it can be ported to another machine. So a lot of good advantage of this virtual machine. This is Python versus Java. That they are very similar, but Java is statically typed, but everything you have to compile it first, and everything you have to run dot class file, and later the variable you have to declare it. But Python is a runtime, so Python is definitely slower in response than Java, maybe 2 to 3 times. But Python is preferred because lot of libraries and all free, and it's a dynamically, so it can be quickly develop your applications, and APIs are good. So Java versus Python app. Save Java, still popular in app development. Java is a great application. So I'll come. These are the very basic things. The evolution of this, you have to just remember, this is a C for loop, this is a Python. Python is just, you have to write it in this. The next slide, it should be like there, and it will be all clear. This is how to write a great common divisor function in Python. So this is the how to declare a function name, def. This is a keyword. Okay, this is a function, these are parameters. This means the beginning of a function, and next lines must be maybe after 2 character, maybe after 4 character, but you have to maintain the same lines. So and this is a simple algorithm. It is almost like if you, I think you all know the what is the difference between algorithm and program. Say algorithm is like English language, like statements comes into it. Step 1, step 2, first begin, step 1, step 2, say whenever you open up any algorithm book, it is Python is almost like a algorithm book. So there is no such very idiosyncrasies. Only thing is make a restraint that you have to be some few characters, maybe 1 or 2 or 4, preferably 4. So it automatically looks say very formatted look. And you don't have to, and like it is swapped, a comma b and b comma is a swap, a to be replaced by b and b to be replaced by a percentage b modulo. So this is a very easy to check the languages. So that's great, this thing. Simple different data types, I have already told, like it is yes, it is error because it is not, this cannot be done in Python, but here it is can be done. This is 1 2 start 3, it is 1 2 1 2 1 2, it will come. I think it is not visible due to some reason or other. Okay, so this is a this is a list, is a list of integers, and this is a list of string. So this is a, and it can be, you it can have a within this, this has to be maybe number, maybe floating one number, anything. List can be embedded into itself, so this is a good tool, and all these things can be embedded. Dictionary can contain dictionary and all these things. List is a collection of items. I told constant access time, like array, linear search time, changeable. Mutable means here great thing about it is C, everything is mutable but changeable. But whenever you see Java, there is a concept of string and string buffer. In Java, the string is immutable. Because string buffer is mutable. So advantage is it has been shown in the runtime, the computer scientists, when they, it's a mutable thing, immutable things like string, or here the tuple, here the this immutable things is much faster in procession, in string processing. And whenever you make it immutable, you have to be processing is very slow. So that's the thing, that is tuple or frozen set is an immutable. And say in the dictionary. In dictionary, you have a key and you have a value. The key has to be immutable. It has to be a tuple or frozen set or immutable or any integer and all this. It should be immutable. Okay. So immutable means you cannot change. It key cannot be a list in dictionary. So that's the whenever you practice it, it will be clear. So like it. List is yeah. This is a tuple, collection of few things, constant access time, that's great, and linear search time, but not changeable, you mean, and can be used as a hash key. That is true. It can be hash key means it can be used as a key value, like this. Okay. So, set, I already covered, set is within second bracket, no second, no random access, single time, no order, dictionary. Yeah, this is a lambda function. Achha, how to get this screen, first of all? So first you go to your Gmail, you open up with Gmail, and then you just Google, anybody can prompt me, Google, and you just say collab, Google collab, you just put it, and the screen is visible to you, yeah, this
yes,
screen,
sir.
Yeah, Google collab,
yes, sir.
Yeah, great,
yes, sir, yes, sir.
Yeah, Google collab, you just find it, and you see a lot of things, then you just say Google collab. And you come to the screen, you can give a, I open up a new screen, you just see here, examples, you say not Colab, you just press the mouse, it will go off, and then you say print new notebook. What is the Colab platform Google is giving is a free platform with GPU so that you can write your Python code. So if you can write Python code, you can just write here print print hello CSC to 2020. It will run. Yeah. The first time it will be slower, but later on it will be faster. Yeah. This is very simple. So you can run Python in Google Colab. You don't have to import anything. Everything is be done by this. But I'll also recommend that you can run Python engine on your machine also, preferably on Linux or Windows. But this is perfectly all right. You can write Python here. You can write a is equal to a equal to 3. And then you say print type of a. I'll come to what is print type of a. Great. And then write print id of a. Then you say print a. Why I am doing this, it will be clear. Hope so it will run. Yeah, it's run. It is a first is hello, that's okay. Then a is a 3, and print type of 3 means a class integer, and this number I will come, what is the significance of this number and this 3. Then you write something, you can write it here, or you can add some code, plus code. You can write, just a minute, you can write b equal to 3 and print id of b. Yeah, great. And print B, yeah. So if you run this code, you just put it and run the code, and you see here the ID number 10114560. It is same. Are you getting? But this, I have taken two variables. A is equal to 3, and B is equal to 3. Can anybody tell me? The reason is because their value is same. Python is creating a object 3, and it create another object A and B reference to that. If you change the value of B, it will change it. But there is no significance what is the ID of B, because they are same, the Python is not using any other place. So if you put here plus code, I just write it b is equal to 4, and I have to write print ID B copy selection is yes, and then see B is equal to 4, now the ID is changed. ID. So, and you can write it print B. Yeah. Now B is equal to 4 and the same. Okay. So, that's it. So, Python has some idiosyncrasies. You never find it. The Python maintains a ID reference, and that is for own use. It is not like a pointer. It is like pointer, but pointer is very hard thing in C. But you can actually get it found. But this ID is Python's own. There is no reason. But that is the key. This is secret. Yeah. Now I'm coming to. I have shown you how to open a IPython notebook by Colab. You just go there. You open a Gmail at one place. You just press another tab window. Write Google Colab and you just get in. And then you just a new notebook, then the notebook will be available. Then you can push your Python code. You write Python code, it will run. Pretty simple. So that's one. And now I want to show this lambda function. What is lambda function? Is the lambda, whenever declared in lambda, it's a one liner function generally. It's like here. What I am doing it here. the x equal to lambda, that is the lambda keyword, a colon, the function started here. This is the body of the function. So I press lambda a and the body of the function, anything, it will be increased by 10. So if you run this, it will be 15. Yeah, this is a 15. If you run it with print say x, there is a 6. It should be 16. I hope so. Let's see, try. Yeah, great. So 15 and 6, so it's just a lambda function. Then you might ask, what is the use of it? Okay, I learned another one thing. Then you can put a lambda function with multiple arguments. Here it is only one. First of all, lambda function is a anonymous function. It's the anonymous, everybody is lambda, and you can say how many lambdas is there. It is generally written function within a function. Say, if you write a function with def, the function name, within this you can write a lambda function, so which is you sometimes you want to repeatedly use in a function, then lambda function is there. It cannot be outside, it cannot be called. In the same body of the function, you can declare a lambda function. There is no name. Lambda, here is a lambda x also here. But you don't have any other thing. You don't have to write def here. That's great. And another thing, it's a single line. It have a single argument, double argument, no argument, so it's possible. That's it. So let's go for this lambda function with here. So lambda, I want to a comma b. I give the two parameters a comma b, and it get the multiplication. So that's it. If you run it, it is run it. The 30 comes, and if you just another two parameters like print x, I give 9, 8. It should come 72, hope so. Let's try. Yeah, there's this thing, 72 comes. So that's the lambda function. So lambda function, then why you are use? It is generally sometimes readability of the code is better, and code would be shorter. It gives some kind of security, you can say, but that is the lambda function. Let's get back to this. I think that's enough for today. You cannot keep concentration. That let's whatever we have done just today, just we summarize in 2-3 minutes. First of all, Python you have to learn quickly, very quickly. It can be learned very quickly. It's very interesting language. These are two extremes. C sometimes whenever my student life, I do not that much amount of like a C. Even Java also. Java is very barbarous. If you have to say hello world, you have to say public, static, void, main, system.out.println within bracket, hello world. But in Python, it just says print hello world, print bracket, hello world. That is great. So whenever if you're thinking and you're writing almost a one-to-one correspondence, the Python is great. In C, you have to have a lot of things you have to write. Why you have to write main? Why you have to write include standard io.h? Why you have to write main void main? And then you have to write printf hello world. But Java is more verbose. You have to write public static void main. You have to understand what is public, what is static, what is void, what is main. Then you have to write system.out.println hello world. So that way Python is great. We can quickly develop, very interesting. You can write GUI, mobile based application, everything is great. So that's it. And another thing I want to mention, Python has lots of data structures built in, so that you can have array. If you want a multi-dimensional array, a NumPy is there. And if that your array has, you have to run on your GPU, graphics processing unit, your mobile phone has a GPU, your laptop right now has a GPU, desktop has a GPU, then you can, it will be much faster, maybe 10 times faster, then it could be a tensor. The tensor can be added by a TensorFlow or this kind of library, and that you see cannot compete with you. Java cannot compete. That you have a huge amount of data, you want to write image data, audio data, you have to run it on your GPU, or you have to run Colab gives you GPU for 12 hours free, then the Python is alternative. And then lots of data structures are there. That is, Python is, first of all, it's a free open source, a lot of requirement in the industry. Now I'm open for your questions, please.
It has been asked me that why exactly Python over Java.
Yeah, so great question.
What should I answer?
Yeah, great is still very good if you for Android app development. But right now the competitor of Java is Kotlin, but Python is a very general purpose language. You can build any application in desktop, Android app, anything. Why you go Python? Because right now demands is more in Python. It likely percentage requirement is earlier, 2-3 years back, Java, but right now Python is heading up. The reason is Java is a kind of lot of restrictions is there from Oracle. You know, Oracle is not an open source company like Microsoft, Oracle is not open source. Anyway, but they do not invest anything on Microsoft proprietary work. Python, and another thing is your code is much less. In Java,
the codes are huge. Yeah.
And if the codes are huge,
it's a bit problematic to solve out the errors, actually.
And another thing is whenever you solve a problem, you write an algorithm. And your algorithm and Python code is almost like 1-to-1 or 1-to-2. In Java, your algorithm to Java code may be 1-to-10. So you are lost in programs. And sometimes if you write, do not write your own programs, you write to debug other.